गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे आई विल कंटिन्यू द लेक्चर्स ऑन बेसिक थर्मोडायनामिक्स. सो लास्ट डे वी हैव सीन द लॉज ऑफ थर्मोडायनामिक्स. बेसिकली वी हैव सीन जीरोथ लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनामिक्स, देन वी हैव सीन द फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनामिक्स. व्हाट वाज द फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनामिक्स? द फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनामिक्स says that in any cyclic process the cyclic integral of q is same as the cyclic integral of w. Then we have manipulated that equation and we have derived several equation for process and for cycle, and then we have seen the for PDB work done and for generalized work done. And one more thing I will tell you, that this cyclic integral of Q is equal to cyclic integral of W is valid for any of the process that is happening in this. Okay, now last year we have seen the concept of internal energy. The concept of internal energy says that from the first law of thermodynamics, that for any process del Q or Q 1 to 2 is equal to del U plus W 1 to 2. So the difference of heat transfer and the work transfer in any process is known as the internal energy of the system, and this internal energy is stored inside the system, or you can say the energy in storage. And this internal energy is a point function, that means it depends only on the two end states, that means initial state or final state, and what is happening in between, it doesn't have any effect on internal energy. But it is opposite for work and heat. Work and heat are the path dependent function. That means it doesn't depend not only on the two end states, it depends on the path. If the path is changed, the values of heat transfer and work transfer will change as per the path. Okay, now today we will see two specific heat at constant volume, specific heat at constant pressure. So let us see. Okay, so now we will see the specific heat at constant volume. Specific heat at constant volume. Now we have to understand what is specific heat. First we have to understand what is specific heat. So don't go through the definitions, just try to make your own definition. So we know the equation as H is equal to MS del T. What is S? This is the specific heat. That means S is equal to H by M into del T. What is H? It is termed as Q, that means the heat, by M into del T. So if M is equal to 1, del T is equal to 1, that means S is equal to Q. So we can say from this equation that to increase the temperature of a unit mass by 1 degree the amount of heat required is termed as specific heat. Okay, so this is the specific heat. Now, what is specific heat at constant volume? Now, what is specific heat at constant volume? So, it is termed as CV or CV. Okay, this CV is for specific for per unit mass, and if the mass is multiplied, then it will be capital CV. Okay, so if mass is 1, then it is small CV. If mass is not 1, then it is capital CV. So what is CV? So CV is defined as, this equation will follow by taking m is equal to 1. So it is del Q by del T at volume is equal to constant. Okay, so similarly, what is specific heat? Specific heat at constant pressure. So it is denoted by small Cp or capital Cp. Small Cp means when the mass is 1, capital Cp when the mass is not equals to 1. Okay, so we will take mass is equal to 1 for this case. So small Cp. So same equation it will follow. Cp is equal to del Q by del T and pressure is equal to constant. Okay, now we will manipulate this term. Now before going to the manipulating these terms and getting out one equation, let me tell you the concept of enthalpy. Enthalpy is a property, of a system whose definition is nothing but U plus PV. That means small h is equal to small u plus p small v. So basically we will use these two. This means enthalpy, this is specific enthalpy. Specific already I have told about that, when the extensive property is divided by mass, then it is termed as specific extensive property. So enthalpy is an extensive property. So if it is divided by mass, then it will be termed as specific enthalpy. So small h is nothing but capital H by m. Okay, so the definition of enthalpy says that it is a summation of internal energy and pressure volume energy. Okay, now we will do the manipulation. Okay, so let us do CV is equal to del Q by del T when volume is equal to constant. Okay, now as per the first law of thermodynamics, it says that del Q is equal to du plus dw. dq is equal to du plus dw. Now if the system is doing pressure displacement work or PDV work, then dq is equal to du plus PDV. Now when volume is equal to constant, when V is equal to constant, then this term will become 0. So we can say dq at volume is equal to constant will come du, and volume is equal to constant. So what will be dq by dt? T means temperature, right? Okay. dq by dt. So rather I can say, I can do it in capital dq by dt. So it will be better to understand temperature. Okay. So what is this? This is nothing but du by dt. Okay. So we can say, that Cv is nothing but du by dt, and volume is equal to constant. So you must remember that the Cv, specific heat at constant volume, is nothing but the changes in the internal energy with respect to the temperature. Now we will do for the specific heat at constant pressure. Now what is the specific heat at constant pressure? Specific heat at constant pressure is nothing but Cp is equal to del Q by del T. This P is equal to constant. Okay. Now to do these things, we will take the help of enthalpy. The enthalpy, you know, we know that H is equal to U plus PV. Now what will be dH? dH is nothing but du plus pdV plus vdP. So I am doing the partial differentiation. Okay. Now when pressure is equal to constant, so dH at pressure is equal to constant, du plus pdV plus this term will be zero. So we can say that dH at constant pressure is nothing but du plus pdV. Now what is the first law of thermodynamics? Just I have told earlier that first law of thermodynamics, when the system is doing pdV work, it is nothing but dQ is equal to du plus pdV. So we can say dQ is equal to du plus pdV. So we can replace this term as like this: dH and pressure is equal to constant, dQ at pressure is equal to constant. Okay. So dQ by dT when pressure is equal to constant is nothing but dH by dT, pressure equal to constant. So Cp will come, nothing but dH by dT, pressure is equal to constant. Okay. So you have to remember these two things, that Cv is nothing but del U by del T, pressure is equal to constant, and Cp is nothing but del H by del T, volume is equal to constant, pressure is equal to constant. So these are the two definition of the two specific heats. That means specific heats means that the changes in the internal energy with respect to temperature, and specific heat at constant pressure is nothing but changes in the enthalpy with respect to pressure. Right? Okay. So this is the end of first law of thermodynamics for closed system. So first law of thermodynamic for closed system, that means no mass is transferring across the system boundary. Okay. So now we will solve one problem and we will see that what is happening. So let me take the problem. So the problem is a bit big, but don't fear, because the thermodynamics problem seems to be big, but the solution is very little, and it requires the not too much high level of mathematical manipulation, but it requires the high level of conceptual things. So to how to read thermodynamics, let me tell you that the way of reading thermodynamics, that whenever you are reading something, not only read, think, because all these things are conceptual things. So the more you grow the concept, the more you will be better in the thermodynamics. Okay, so let us solve this problem right now. So let me decide the problem. So the problem says the internal energy of a certain substance is given by the following equation. U is equal to 3.6 PV plus 84, where U is given in kilojoule per kg, P is given in kPa, and V is given in meter cube per kg. Okay. So this is per unit kg, but that means specific internal energy. Now a system composed of 3 kg of the substances expands from an initial pressure of 500 kPa and a volume of 0.22 meter cube to final pressure 100 kPa in a process in which pressure and volume are related by PV to the power 1.2 is equal to constant. Now A, if the expansion is quasi-static, find Q, del U and W for the process. In another process, the same system expands according to the same pressure volume relation as in part A, and from the same initial state to the same final state as in part A, but the heat transfer in this case is 30 kilojoules. Find the work transfer for this process. Explain the difference in work transfer in part A and B. Okay, so to solve this kind of problem, you have to first think what is happening. So as per the problem, that we can see that we have a system. Okay, and in the system there is some certain gas or some substances whose weight or whose mass is 3 kg. Okay, and it was initially at these conditions 500 kPa and volume 0.22 meter cube, and then some process is happening, and because of the process it has gone to the final pressure 100 kPa and the volume is not provided. Okay, and it has been told that the volume and pressure and volume related to this equation. So seeing this equation, you have to judge what type of equation it is. So you can see that our index is given, that means this process is nothing but polytropic process. This process is nothing but polytropic process. So we'll use the concept of polytropic process. Okay, now what you have to find out? So before going to that, let me draw the diagram. So it is any PV diagram. Okay, so initially it was at 500 kPa, finally it has gone to 100 kPa. So it was state 1, it has gone to state 2. So it is 500 kPa, kPa, and this one is 100 kPa. The volume is given, 0.22 meter cube, and this volume is not given. So what we have to do, we have to find out what is Q, what is del U, what is W for part A. This is part A. Okay, so what are the equations available to us? We have equation available, Q is equal to del U plus W. Q122 is equal to W122. Here is also 122, which is 122. Okay. Okay, so we have to find out Q. So first we will find out del U. So how to find out del U? Del U is a point function. So del U is nothing but U1, U2 minus U1. U2 minus U1. U2 minus U1. So how we will get this? So U2 will use this equation to find out this equation. It is nothing but 3.56 P2V2 plus 84 minus 3.56 P1V1 minus 84. So this one will cut down. So it is coming 3.56 P2V2 minus V1 V1, right? Now we don't have the value of P2 V2. Okay, now let us see what the values are given. So this is P1, this is V1. Okay, this is P2, this is V2. So P2 is given, V2 is not given. V1 is given, V1 is given. So how we could find out V2? So we will follow this equation. This equation. So PV to the power 1.2 is equal to constant. That means P1 V1 to the power 1.2 is equal to P2 V2 to the power 1.2. So what will be V2 to the power 1.2? It is nothing but P1 V1 to the power 1.2 by P2 to the power 1 by 1.2. Okay. So if we do the calculation, it will come as the calculation is already been, I've already done the calculation. So it will come 0.845 meter cube. Okay. Now we'll put it in this equation. So if we put it in this equation, 3.56 multiplied by P2 is how much? P2 is 100 into 0.845 minus P1, P1 is how much? 500 multiplied by V1, V1 is given 0.22. So if you do the calculation, it will come 90 minus 91 kilojoule. This minus sign has a great significance in this problem. So delu is nothing but minus 91 kilojoule. Okay, now we'll find out work done. So as this is a polytropic process, so already I have done the calculation for the work done. It is nothing but P1 V1 minus P2 V2 by N minus 1. So what is P1? P1 is 500 into V1 is 0.22 minus P2 is how much? P2, how much you have got? 100 into 0.845 by N is the polytropic index, that means 1.2. So N is the polytropic index, that means it is 1.2. So it is coming as 1.2 minus 1. So if you do the calculation, the result will come 127.5 kilojoule. Okay, now we have to find out. So look at over there, for quasi static process we have got the changes in the delu and then the work transfer. Okay, now simply you have to apply the first law of thermodynamics to find out the Q122. So it is nothing but delu plus W122 is equal to minus 91 kilojoule plus 127.5 kilojoule. So the result will come as 36.5 kilojoule. So Q122 is 36.5 kilojoule. Okay, so this is W122, 1227, and delu is this. So we have got the three result that we have to find it out. Okay, now it indicates, that means during this process heat is coming into the system, it indicates. So this is the significance of this problem. Then we'll move on to the part 2. So in the part 2, it says that there is another process for the same system. Okay, so the system is same. Okay, the system is same.
Okay,
So here one mass will be multiplied each every term. Their mass will be multiplied. That means it will be multiplied by 3. Then the result will come like this. Okay. Then the result will come like this. Okay. So next we have to find out. We have to find out the work done. Okay. So we are neglecting the mass. So just forget this mass. Just we are doing these things for per unit mass, because all these things are given in per unit kg. Okay, all the things are given in per unit kg. Okay, so let us solve this problem part 2. So in the another process, the system expands according to the same pressure volume relationship. Okay, so there is another system just like this. Okay, here the system is changing its states from state 1 to state 2, but there is a basic difference that in this case heat is transferred 30 kilojoule. Positive 30 kilojoule means the heat is coming inside the system. Okay, now you have to find out the work transfer. So to find out this, we will use the same formula. Q1 to 2 is equal to del U plus W1 to 2, right? Now U is a path point function. It means that it only depends on the points, initial point and the final point. That means the value of del U will not change, so it will be same as minus 91. Now Q is 30 kilojoule, it is as per the problem. Del U is 91, so W1 to 2 is nothing but minus 91 will come plus 91 plus 30 kilojoule, so it is 121 kilojoule. So pretty simple. Okay, so the work done will come 121 kilojoule. Okay, for the second part, that means if it is a path A, if it is path B, then for the next case, path B, the work done is 121 kilojoule, and for the path A, the work done is 127.5 kilojoule. Okay, now what is told? Explain the difference between work and transfer. So I am not writing, I am just explaining. So as the path has been changed, that means in the previous case the heat input was 36.5 kilojoule, but here the heat input is 30 kilojoule. That's why there is a changes in the heat transfer. Though the system is following the same end state, that means the initial state and the final states are identical for both the cases. That means for both the cases, state 1 is same, state 2 is same, but in between the path is different. That's why the path is different, the heat transfer has been changed, and the work transfer has also been changed. So for the path A, the work transfer is 127.5 kilojoule. For path B, the work transfer is 121 kilojoule, because the heat and work are two path functions. That's why that is the difference. So this is the solution of this problem. See you in the next class.